Somewhere in our souls is a spiritual Canada. Its bedrock is of snow and ice, winter and the land. And if we were to penetrate it a little deeper, chances are we'd find a game. My name is Ken Dryden. I've been involved in hockey most of my life. As a son and father, a fan, as player, coach, now player again. In the next several hours, we will try to penetrate that bedrock to find a game that is both real and mythical. It's a game that tells stories about kids and growing up, small towns and big cities, about television, spectacle, and selling pure and simple. About people wandering into bigger worlds and trying to live in them. About play and ideals and real life that tests them both and makes us wonder. It is a game about us. This room, saw its sight, heard its sound, time flew by. Always I wanted to stop it, hold on to it. Tonight I get another chance. In hockey's greatest theater, it's the Edmonton Oilers, the team of the 1980s, and the Montreal Canadians, the team for all time. One more chance to see and feel a game from the inside. 10 years ago, I exited this frozen stage. Another is about to enter. Finland's Jyrki Lumme will play his first game tonight. Just blocks away, also from Finland, his opponent and idol, Jari Kurri.
Jyrki Lumme, they play?
No.
Jyrki Lumme?
Lumme. I guess he'd be his hero, huh?
They're mere players in this messy, uncontrollable drama, and each plays his part, the star, the rookie, and the poor kid who unimaginably grew up to coach his mythical team. Early in the day, they're just passing time. In a few hours, the tension of time will hit them. Time is endless, yet time is running out. The game is coming, and nothing can stop it. Gretzky did said, I'm magic, you can't beat me. Messier says it with a bone-chilling look. Kevin Lowe from nearby Lachute. Make it to the NHL and everyone's your cousin. Messier feels the burdens of this Gretzky-less team. They need more scoring, more leadership. Sometimes he tries too hard. Here among friends, like kids at play, they rehearse moves they've made 1,000 times before, making sure what was there yesterday is still there today.
Weird about the way the sun is. I got a shot.
Lunch in an hour, nothing until then. Time to linger, let the clock catch up.
Kevin, I need money. They won't let you. Can't leave the tickets to your mum's COD, period.
Yeah.
So, and all I've got are the white.
The toughest part of Kevin Lowe's day. Okay. He gets two tickets. He needs more.
My grandmother.
Family and friends are always checking to see if the NHL star is still the kid next door.
Tickets aren't problem, so I wanted to get them. Wanted to get them in the lower red so they didn't have to walk up too high, and just so they could see better too, you know.
I've got two really good ones.
Do you? Yeah. That you're not using, or?
Well, you can trade you off.
I don't want to. I'll see if I can talk to.
I'll tell you what.
I'm going to talk
to the
Canadians.
Fans are always there in the early morning, late at night, win or lose. I watched them grow up. They watched me grow old. The autograph tells them once they got right up close. It tells us we are important. Fans give at least as much as they get.
And I got a nice souvenir from you. I got one of your sweaters.
Oh, your jacket?
The original one that you wear once, or maybe more than once, and I got it.
Yeah.
And somebody offered me $1,000 for it, and I refused it. And I got it. Oh, yeah, I refused it. That's a souvenir I'm going to keep for my boy.
Oh,
but it's a good souvenir for me.
Yeah. Well,
okay,
great.
See you.
Bye.
See you later. Bye.
Everybody knows.
A care package from the Lowe family dairy.
Well, it's the time, the care and the love that goes into the ice cream. It's just not, you know, it's just not made artificially or commercially. I mean, this is homemade stuff.
Beer was never the same since you left the dairy.
This is true.
When you came to training camp as a rookie, you were 220 pounds of fat. And now you're 196 pounds of dynamite, and this ice cream is fattening you up when you're a kid.
There you go.
1:05 p.m. Colleen Ganey, youngest of the four Ganey kids.
Snoopy. Where's Snoopy? We're here. Snoopy's not in today.
Stephanie, the one I gave her.
Oh. And she liked it.
One of the kids isn't here. Steven, who is 9, is at a tournament in Boston and scored 6 goals in his first game, almost a season's total for his dad.
Mm-hmm. Sure, hon.
Did Dad get his fourth goal?
Steven, Daddy? Daddy, I think he's at 5 now.
5 what?
5 goals. She said, did you get
you
4
get
goals?
In the game. You're at 5.
p.m. A Canadiens player has been suspended. Even the Oilers feel affected.
The more often they show it, the worse it gets.
To Lowe, it's trial by TV.
Mm-hmm. Well, when you go to see Brian O'Neill, they slow it up and everything, just like you, staying in your situation. They slow it up and it looks like you deserve life. Not 6 games. And his, when they showed it in the news, they slowed it up. It looks like he directed his elbow right in his face, but I mean, this is a reaction.
You know, okay, ready?
Did you want that in your shirt?
On the day of a game, I wanted only to get through its hours, unhurt, untired, unbothered, to escape completely from the game, from all feelings of time, by walking, eating, sleeping, watching TV, thinking of other things, or nothing.
Andy and I have roomed together for 9 years now, and see these little things?
2:13, Messier and Glenn Anderson.
I rule the roost of the room. I rule the roost.
That's a lie.
I run the room. Every time we come into the room,
the room with Foggy.
I control it. I control the TV and Glenn has to watch it.
Well, now you know he's lying right now because he used to room with Foggy before, but now, since nobody else would room with him, they have to put me with him so that he'd stay under control.
Now is when the game used to hit me. My mind far away, my feet start tapping, my fists clenching, unclenching, my world speeding up. PM. Still too much time, still not enough to do. But now Messier feels the irresistible need to do something, to move, to get ahead of time just to slow it down, to avoid the urgency of the game as long as he can. For each performance, it's the same. Hurry up and wait.
To deliver adult pain relief.
Why did I switch?
Why do people switch to Anacin? That's why.
You know, there's some things in this world your nose will tell you how they taste before you ever get them to your mouth. Like the hot apples and cinnamon in this Quaker ready-to-serve oatmeal. Puts me and my pal here in mind of hot apple pie. But you know, pie don't seem like the right thing to do for breakfast. Oatmeal does. Quaker, ready to serve oatmeal. The right thing to do. Tasty way to do it.
It was here I listened to a knowledgeable voice encouraging me from behind. And it was here I sat a little longer than I wanted to when I didn't follow through. It was here I jumped up wildly to bang my stick on the boards when everything went right. And I stared down at my skates when things went wrong.
The game of hockey is one of our best schools for learning discipline, responsibility, and hard work. That's why at ESSO, we think our involvement in this great sport is important.
With so much in life incomplete, it's nice to find something that isn't for a change. When you buy a Tempo or Topaz L with the value package, it comes complete with dual electric mirrors, air conditioning, AM/FM stereo, even automatic transmission. It's a complete package that for $12,995 makes complete sense.
The game is inescapable now. I'd always leave little things undone just to keep busy. To blank my mind, to let emotion fill me up, sweep me forward. Music helps. Hockey is lived and played to a rock beat. The Canadians watch what Burns wants them to see, but they won't see much. Their minds flicker in and out of the room, caught on the coattails of the game. PM, the city comes to life. Scalpers, program sellers, pizza and hot dog vendors, it's their game too. The music is shut off, the countdown continues.
Look at the board here for a second.
Glenn Sather writes the Oilers script, but this is sport, not theater. The Canadians, with their own plans, will frustrate Sather any way they can, and new scripts must be improvised. Still, there's an our game and a their game. Sather tells his players, if we play our game to our script, we will win.
A couple of places we're having some problems. One of them is if they shoot the puck in, and these guys are going to shoot the puck in, if they shoot it in Yari's corner over here, and he's back checking with this guy, and their man has the puck here, he shoots it in this corner, our defenseman tries to stand up a little bit. You've got to go back in here with the guy. And even if you don't have a guy in the puck to shot in, a lot of times the forward should get this puck. And where we've been getting in trouble is our forwards go here, the defenseman goes there, and you end up with your ass against the glass all the time. This puck should be the forward puck, not the defenseman's puck.
Serious, silent till pent up energy can stand it no longer. Imploding, exploding, idling engines begin to rev higher.
Well, be careful when they shoot the puck, you gotta delay them. And the other thing is a little piss spot, he makes a turn in here all the time and tries to get somebody coming in.
Nothing. Of course, he's the referee. He's going to give him a speed one, that's for sure. Stay away from him. Stay away from him.
Shoot up at 10 yards for a
moment. You've got to make sure you have the trailer and their defense come up. What's the Finnish guy's name? Lume comes up. You've got to watch him.
What time? 9 minutes. Sather's script is clear. On defense, watch Naslund and Lume. Play the Canadians the way we always have, tight and low scoring, their game. And with better scores, our game will win it at the end.
Well, we got to go to 100,000 or so. Grab the bat. This needs to go better, guy. Guys, let's just be patient out here now. Let's be patient. Work hard, be patient. We can work out last year, guys.
Okay, got a couple of points here. Sure, you're not going to score on him from a big long shot out. The guy's quick and the guy's fast. Okay. You get up close on him, fake him. He goes down a lot. You can get a foot through his pads. Second shot, if you do get a second shot on him, he's down a lot. Try to get it upstairs.
Burns presents a defensive script.
Work down deep, two guys. Try to fight them down too deep for the puck. Get that third guy sitting high, coming in late, and try to get to that guy. Don't get overcrowded in there. Don't get over anxious. One man up, hey guys, make sure. I'm not worried. We're going to score goals. I'm not worried about that. I'm worried how many they're going to score. So let's be patient. Make sure that you don't over forecheck. Don't get caught three guys in deep. Don't get beat by a pass. All right, make sure of that. But don't be under aggressive either. Make sure if you got a hit that you're going to take, give it to them.
Keep the score down. Forget the pretty plays. Go to the net.
Watch their long passes, hey guys? Watch their long passes. We're going to try them all the time. So that's make sure that you don't get caught up way too much and they'll be able to hit you with the long pass. If we end up 2-on-2, what's the problem? We don't want to be outnumbered when they're attacking. Okay, Carp, you're starting. Lutz and Chili.
Burns wants his best checkers, Carbonell, Ganey, and Walters, to start head-to-head against the Messier line. Three minutes to go. Every period, every game, it's the same. Carbonell taps Robinson. Waugh moves forward, crouches. Scrudland slaps both pads, then Hayward, and they're off. Every word, every stick tap, every punch and slap is part of the routine they need to win. In war, soldiers live and soldiers die. Why me, each wonders? Why a hat trick? Why a goalpost? Why do the gods do as they do? It's the mystery of performance. And if we don't know why, let's pretend it has to do with ritual. Carbonell must wait. Naslund must slip into his place in line. Then Carbonell, then Green, Ludwig is last every time. The curtain goes up. But these aren't actors. When they're cut, they bleed. Each game, they give a performance of their lives. Ambition, hope, pride. Here, the stuff of life is played out. Hockey is Canada's game. It may also be our national theater. More ritual. Parvino, Ludwig, and Robinson join Waugh in a receiving line. Naslin, 26, skates into the picture and faces them from in front. From stage left, Chelios and Corson enter. Robinson, right, looks around for Green to bump in from behind, then trips into action. Naslin waits for Robinson, then swoops in on Waugh. This frees Ludwig, then Carbonell. Yet more ritual. The tenor rouses the crowd. The players vibrate in place. Patrick Waugh talks with his goalpost. Messier against Carbonell, the scorer against the checker. Carbonell must establish a defensive groove. Messier, avoid an early Canadiens goal that will send a day's worth of plans into a giant spin and the game out of control. He wants to subdue the forum crowd that's now holding back, afraid of declaring real hope for fear the champion Oilers will play with that hope and crush it. And mostly he wants to deliver a withering message to Carbonell and the Canadiens. You want to beat us? Maybe you can. But if you try, we'll put you through hell every minute, every shift. So how much do you really want to win? And then it happens. Carbonell blocks a shot, a breakaway. He looks up. His brain takes in everything. He knows an Oiler's behind him and won't catch up. He never turns to see. He remembers other games against Fuhr, other chances. Like Star Wars fighters in each other's sights, they lost. Seconds, the Canadiens take the lead. What Sather didn't want. Still, plenty of time. Don't try to get it back on the next shift. Stick with the game plan.
Smitty, you take the first defenseman, Smitty.
But now against a louder, more confident crowd.
You take the next one.
It's harder. Millions watch at home. Claude Lemieux jumps onto their screen and out again. The cameras follow the puck. It's the only way most people will ever see the game. But if we forget the puck and bring the cameras up close, it's a game of people. Watch the same action again. Seconds in the life of Claude Lemieux. His wife watches from the crowd. It's their size that always surprises me. So big and thick, their speed, the confusion, the congestion, no time, no space, no place to hide. An opening, big bodies close in and it's gone. This way, that way, turning back on itself again and again, no pattern it seems. Players cruise around, looking, sensing which way the game will go, then burst ahead of it till it changes again. There's such fury to it, the humping, the crashing, the racing around, often too fast to see, to appreciate, to admire. It has a terrible beauty that goes straight to the gut. No goals, no assists, no penalties, no shots on goal, nothing happened. Down the rookie Jyrki Lumme. It doesn't take long.
If you don't have full control, they're going to go right at you. Okay, that's it. Go back to the slot now. Go back to the slot. Good play. Good. That's it. That's it. That's the one.
The goal scorer, Jyrki Lumme. The mystery of performance, the wonder of fate. Two objects moving in different directions. Messier skates, Lumet's puck, colliding. And the fates are changed. Fuhr was in position to stop that puck. Messier made a great effort to block it. Now both are wondering, what's going on here? Why me? Why tonight? As for Lumet, he'll never be the same. Thrilled to death. Larry Robinson playing in his 1,152nd NHL game, Jyrki Lumme, his first. The Oilers get another penalty late in the period. Messier tries to kill it off. Watch it skate. Kind of period. Canadians 3, Oilers 1. Barefoot and whistling, like Huck Finn, Naslund returns with a goal.
Great play, Carl.
Presenting this week's great news from Sears. Starring Tradition All Leather Dress Shoes for Men at 45% off. Now just $38.50 a pair. At Sears, where you get your money's worth and more.
Gillette announces a razor that can sense the individual needs of your face. Introducing the extraordinary Gillette Sensor Shaving System. Sensor blades are mounted on responsive springs to continuously sense and adjust to your face for the best shave a man can get. Closer, smoother, safer. New Gillette Sensor.
We're here to find out which of these tape players will last the longest and to see whether music makes chickens lay more eggs. The yellow bird has entertained the longest. But you're itself, the one that lasts. And as for that egg theory.
Oh, I have a feeling I got deep in my stomach before every single game.
Wait, open.
The butterfly. Everyone else had it too. You could tell.
Okay. Let's go.
I'll never forget that feeling. Ever.
The game of hockey has taught many of us the meaning of team spirit. Another reason why at Esso, we think our involvement in this great sport is important.
Presenting this week's great news from Sears. Starring Tradition All Leather Dress Shoes for Men at 45% off. Now just $38.50 a pair. At Sears, where you get your money's worth and more.
Mark Messier sees his game as a series of personal one-on-one battles. Whoever wins the most will win the war.
The defenseman goes down. The other guy goes behind the net, and the performer comes back.
The second time.
And see what happens. You went over. I went in the held zone. As soon as he started walking, I backed up to my point, and the guy couldn't get there in time.
Yeah. Spent a little too much time in our end, 5 against 5 with the Alex. We did that.
And we are either that or neutral end.
We've got to get the puck off the door.
Their defense is coming right down in the corner.
We've got to give our defenseman another second, and we've got to get the puck off the board, up the middle of the ice.
The guys that are open, though, we're going to get.
Is that amazing?
Well, you don't want to see
the guy in the house. Yeah. Or maybe I looked too quick and I saw. I knew that somebody was there, but I just wanted to, like, I trapped Anderson about here. Okay. I got him on the outside. There's no way he could catch me. As soon as I went out across the blue line, where did you go? And you laid it to Wally, I went right at the goalpost. I thought you were behind me. No, because I went. Why is the fucker on here somewhere? I looked, but I saw somebody, but I thought it was one of them. So that's why I started moving this way. I don't want you to drop it. I'm going to the net. Okay. I'm going to the net. But if you had passed it on my side, if you had just passed it right across, I'm right there. I would have skated right into it.
Ken, you know the pass you made to Wally, right? You put it around Wally hard. Right there.
Yeah.
The first period, the Oilers and Messier lost more battles than they won. But the gloom has lifted. The Oilers can sense the change. It's their turn now.
Our defenseman turned around. I had a winger sitting here at the red line skating backwards, waiting for the loose puck. So let's get back into our own end and let's help each other out.
Out in the same order, tapping, slapping in just the same way. The fates were with us the first period. Don't change the luck. Fuhr can't shake that first period. Every goal seemed like a hard shot. Still, three goals. He can't remember. Were they hard shots? Is it just one of those nights for the team, for me? If I can just get through these next few minutes, if I can change the pattern, then maybe we can still make something of this game. But everything's fragile. Fuhr's confidence, the confidence of his teammates and coaches in him. And every next goal will only bring back the memory of every goal before. The Oilers are certain this period will be different. Fuhr thinks, I must not break that spirit. I can't let in a goal till we get at least one ourselves. Fuhr masks his insecurities. Waugh wears his. His head bobbing like a car ornament. His body moving when there's nothing to move for. He reaches for his goalposts, just to touch them, to know they're no wider apart than the last time. But watch him when the puck nears. His conscious mind goes blank, fears disappear. He is like a rock. Patrick Waugh must stop the Oilers' surge, frustrate it till it runs its course, till his teammates come back. Give his team what it needs when it needs it. Counter every rhythm of the game. Be strong when the rest are weak. Canadians didn't need Waugh the first period. They need him now. Still pressing. Say there again delivers the emotion that's missing. Irresistible happens. But one goal isn't a problem. It's when snakes become ladders, when a single and a walk turns into a big inning. That's what loses games. The Canadians must gain control. Instead, 16 seconds later, Brian Scrublin gets a penalty. Just one short moment in an evening's drama. Many different reactions to it. Happy Ganey and daughter Laura. Jesse Lowe, Kevin's mother.
Kill a penalty, honey. Gonna kill the penalty now. Daddy, that is to say, Austin may have 5 minutes, but he'll have four. One of our men is a penalty box, so Dad has to start. Oh, shoot it, Kevin. Come on, Craig.
Huddy hadn't slipped, his path would not have been so slow. Larry Robinson wouldn't have thought he could intercept it. He wouldn't have left the front of the net. Glenn Anderson wouldn't have been open. The goal wouldn't have been scored. The wonder of fate. On the Canadiens bench, the ghosts of too many Oilers games past start to appear, where solid leads and hopes suddenly vanish. The NHL is spectacle, like a rock show or Phantom of the Opera. But now spectacle has a more urgent purpose. The Canadiens need help. Just the right mix of sound and light to set the home crowd roaring. The organist becomes their seventh player. Turns again. Naslund scores. The Canadiens take the lead 4-3. And with less than a minute left in the second period, the Canadiens score again. Then the Oilers score, and the period ends, the Canadiens leading 5-4. Pullum, Glenn Sather asks John Muckler, they're talking about removing the league's best goalie. Bill Ranford, the Oilers' other goalie, will play the third period. Teammates and competitors, only one can play at a time. They hope for each other, hope harder for themselves.
Bed only measures 4 by 6 feet. A steel frame with a net on the back. And a couple of coats of red paint. How is it that something so simple could get me to push myself like never before? The game of hockey has let so many of us experience the thrill of winning. Another reason why at Esso, we think our involvement in this great sport is important.
Life without cholesterol.
I mean, how much lettuce can one man endure? Give up the best things in life. What's left?
New Miracle Whip Light Dressing. 40% less fat than regular, and it's cholesterol-free. Same tangy zip as regular Miracle Whip and no cholesterol. So you get all the taste and no cholesterol.
I do?
Cholesterol-free Miracle Whip Light. The best things in life are cholesterol-free.
Thank you. Thank you.
All of the Tuckers help after supper, putting the food away. Wrapping with Glad the dinner they had to save for another day. The Touch Stick Spot helps them a lot, and it's always easy to tear. Glad wraps just right, doesn't put up a fight, and it has strength to spare. Food's as fresh as can be, and tastes heavenly. It's easy when Glad is there.
I've been in the wine business for over 50 years, and every year my Carlo Rossi wines get better and better. Like my wife's ravioli. I married my wife because of these ravioli. Of course, she has other good qualities too. That's where my Carlo Rossi wine is best. With friends and good food. I like talking about Carlo Rossi wine, but I'd rather drink it.
You find yourself even too high up the guy.
Glenn Sather's low-scoring script hasn't happened. Still, the Oilers can now feel it. The game is close, and with better scores, we're going to win it at the end, just as we planned. When he sees Bill Ransford in the Oilers net, longtime hockey writer Red Fisher isn't surprised.
He can't get up. Right?
Wrong.
Right? Can't get up.
Well, one or the other anyway.
No, he's playing terribly. Grant Fuhr.
Not sick, not tired or injured, Fuhr just can't figure out what's wrong. It's like the beginning of the game again. Plenty of time to go, just get in a groove. Then Carboneau will stick out his skate, steal the puck, and find an opening. Again, the game turns on its ear. Early in this game, it took only seconds for the Oilers to recover. But this goal is a kick in the stomach. It'll take minutes to get over, and not many minutes remain. Ransford makes four saves, but the one that matters is the one he didn't make.
There's a fairly important ingredient in this one.
What's that?
Number 99.
Tonight, 99 is in Calgary with his Los Angeles Kings, the guy who isn't here, but who's everywhere. He was the life energy that bound his team together. Minus Gretzky, goal scorers must score more often, but get fewer chances. He is now their crutch. When they lose, they can blame the man who made the trade, and now they lose more often. Sather talks with Jimmy Carson.
Play the puck back to his point, man. The right wingers can drop to the spot, like you can use Yari or Pick.
Yeah.
And then let them hammer the puck. Play the puck to the board.
Okay.
And then you get the puck, pass to the defenseman, and bing.
How do I get the puck if I throw it to the board?
You pass to the board, as soon as you shoot it there, go over and get it.
Oh, you mean that, like the Gretzky always does?
Yeah.
Oh,
is a game about time. For the great player, time is endless. He creates time, practicing movements over and over to do them faster, learning a game's shortcuts from experience, waiting that extra beat, undistracted by thoughts and fears, holding back until the last moment, until he is ready and every option is clear. For the Oilers, time is running out. Practices belong to the coaches. Games belong to the players. There's not much Sather can now do as he feels this game slip away. Change his lines more often. Pick an argument with the referee. Anything to interrupt the fatal rhythm. Put on his tough guy against theirs and hope his guy wins. Not much else. Esa Tikkanen has his tricks too and creates a penalty. This may be the Oilers' last best chance. Upright when you're halfway on your side. and before 11 minutes to go, Sather looks at his team, winning, their bodies swell, their chests puff out. Now they're shriveling up. Then the fates intervene. An Oiler skates through the crease and knocks Wah over. 7-5. The first law of sports is momentum.
Come on, boys, not over yet. Come on, let's go, Gritty, come on.
If something happens, then something else can happen, then something else, and the impossible becomes possible.
All right, I gotta pull a goalie here. I'm gonna pull a goalie. Check. Come here. I'm talking to my lungs. Pull a goalie. You get the draw back. Stick you on the outside. Yara, you pick the guy on the inside. Mark, come here. Charlie's going to get the puck in the corner. Yari's going to get the puck. Stick this guy. Chick's going to get past you behind the net. You pass to Carson in front. Give it to Chick if you can. Shoot it in. Yari's going to pick the guy off.
Get the face off. Score a quick goal. We'll be up. The Canadians will panic. We can get another. And for the Oilers and Canadians, it makes absolute sense.
Well, I'm doing that play. Got a playbook?
Canadian 7, Oilers 5. Just one more game out of 80, but it isn't. Nothing counts until the playoffs, but it does. We are the champions. We can win this year even without Gretzky. But again, we didn't prove it.
Moi, je dis que c'est pas vraiment l'équipe la plus vite que moi j'ai vue à date, là, de toutes les équipes qu'on a rencontrées. On m'a dit une affaire, mais c'est tout un train quand ça passe.
A good night for Burns and his players. We saw the Stanley Cup champions and beat them. We've seen each other under fire and came through. Before the game, Sather and Burns wrote almost the same script. Tight checking, patience, low scoring. Nothing went the way they expected. Watch Naslund, watch Lume, Sather warned. Naslund scored 3 goals, Lume 1. The confusion of action, the randomness of fate, the pressure of time. Hockey is real life.
The time I spend at work is important to me, but so is the quality time I want to spend with my family and friends, even when I have cold symptoms, like nasal congestion. That's why I count on Sudafed. It gives me fast relief and lets me stay alert.
When you want to keep going, Sudafed has an effective decongestant that relieves your stuffy nose, so you can get on with your busy day and your quality time. Sudafed, fast relief that lets you stay alert.
Pulling power. Which full-size pickup truck has the most? We took the truck with the biggest standard engine and put it up against the truck with the most standard torque. And let them pull. And the answer is, it's the truck with both. Ford F-Series has the biggest engine and the most torque. the best-selling truck in Canada, is number one for all the right reasons.
Take some tasty wheat. Make up little baskets. Then take the taste of your favorite fruit. What have you got? The idea behind Nabisco strawberry wheat, apple and cinnamon wheat, and raisin wheat. They're weedy little baskets with real fruit inside. Yeah, new Nabisco strawberry wheat. Weedy little baskets with fruit. Nabisco basket.
When it comes to renovations, there's no place like home. Because you'll find more than friendly advice. You'll find the right tools. Quality brand names like Black & Decker, Benchmark, and Makita. And, of course, great prices. So remember, when it comes to renovations, there's no place like home.
Welcome home.
Happens every Friday night. The whole town crams into that arena like one big happy family. Every one of us cheering on the kids and trying to keep warm. And you know something? Win or lose, we all go home with a really good feeling inside. I wouldn't miss these nights for anything.
For generations, the game of hockey has brought our communities a little closer together. That's why at Esso, we think our involvement in this great sport is important.
It's the wedding of the year on...